Hi, hello, welcome to Harika's Home Cooking. Today I'm going to show you how to make Kutti Vankaya curry. So these are the ingredients we need. We need 4 to 5 tablespoons of peanuts, 3 to 4 tablespoons of desiccated coconut and 4 cloves, 2 cardamoms and 1 inch cinnamon stick. Then I have taken 1 small size lemon, tamarind and soaked it in the warm water and 1/4 tablespoon of methi seeds, 1 tablespoon of coriander seeds and 1 tablespoon of cumin seeds, 2 tablespoons of sesame seeds and 1/2 medium sized onion finely chopped, 4 garlic cloves and 1 ginger that is like around 2 inches and few curry leaves, then turmeric powder, paprika powder, red chili powder, salt and also we want the main ingredient, the brinjal. It's a purple brinjal. So I'll be showing you how to cut them and we need to soak them in the warm water after cutting them in the desired shape. So I'll be cutting the plus shape in the bottom of the brinjal so that we can stuff the masala in it. So you need to be cutting in X or plus whatever. So after cutting it, soak them in the salt water. That doesn't make the brinjal brown in color. So I have taken a wok, added the peanuts and my cinnamon stick and my cloves and the cardamoms and fry them until the peanuts are golden brown in color. So make this process in the medium to low flame because we don't want to burn the peanuts or any masala. As my wok is heat, it doesn't take much time. So I'm adding my rest of the ingredients. So I'm adding methi seeds, coriander seeds, cumin seeds, sesame seeds and give a good mix and cook in medium flame. So keep on stirring so the spices doesn't burn. We are looking for around golden color. So once all my masala is almost ready, I'll be adding my desiccated coconut because the coconut doesn't take much time to cook. There are a lot of chances that they might burn if you cook in the beginning. So once everything is done, I put my flame off and I made them cool. Then we'll make into a fine coarse paste. We will be adding very little water. We doesn't want the masala to be runny. So after my masala is cool, I'm blending it in the mixer jar. I'm adding my cloves and also ginger and I'll be adding a little bit of turmeric powder, paprika powder, red chili powder and also a little bit of salt. I'm adding the salt only according to the masala and we will be adding the rest of the salt when we cook our curry. And add a little bit of water and make it a fine paste. And take a wok, add oil. After your oil is ready, it's hot, add the mustard seeds, cumin seeds, curry leaves, then my onions. So once you see this mustard seeds spluttering, add curry leaves and then onions and cook the onions until golden brown in color. So in the meanwhile, we are going to stuff the masala in the brinjals, in the eggplants. So here I started stuffing my eggplants. I'm showing few how to do that. So we will be having little bit of extra masala. No need of getting worried about that. We will be adding that masala too to make the gravy consistency. So stuff all your eggplants and keep it aside. In the meanwhile, our onions will be cooking. So once your onions start turning brown in color, we will be adding the eggplants. So I add a little bit of salt, very little, and a little bit of turmeric and give it a good mix and then add the eggplants. Arrange your eggplants on the bottom of the pan so that all the brinjals will touch the pan and cook evenly. if you use a better wide pan, it will be great. So I'm flipping my brinjals after a while. And again close the lid and cook for a few minutes. So after a few minutes my brinjal looks like this, and make sure you're keeping your flame very low. So now I'll be adding my rest of the masala and mix it well and close the lid. So after opening my lid, my brinjals are almost half cooked. Now I'll be adding the tamarind juice and also the rest of the water which is scraped from the masala, and use this kind of spatulas for not making the brinjals break. So you might smash your brinjals if you use the wooden spatulas. If you have any kind of silicone, better use them so that your brinjals will not be smushy. So now I'm adding little bit of salt and also chili powder. You can taste your curry. If you feel like you need some, you can add too. So now mix it well. Again cook until you see the oil on the top of the gravy. That's the right consistency. See, my curry is ready now. You can see the oil on the top. It's ready to serve. Now enjoy.
Subscribe to my channel if you love cooking.
If you like my channel, please
and also press the bell icon so you can get latest videos notifications for free. Thank you.